The Brevard County Sheriff's Office is investigating after deputies say a woman shot a man to death in a Port St. John neighborhood.
Yeah, right now, no one is facing charges in the case. That shooting happened just after 10 o'clock last night in a home on Lindsay Avenue off Fay Boulevard. Channel 9's Melanie Holt is live there now. Mel, you were there as investigators collected some additional evidence today.
And they're still conducting interviews in this case, but the sheriff's office told me that this situation was confined to the people in the home where this shooting took place.
I'd say probably once a month, first police, sir. It's an ongoing saga.
Neighbors near the intersection of Covina Street and Lindsay Avenue weren't surprised by the presence of the sheriff's office in their Port St. John neighborhood. This time, it was to investigate the shooting death of a 32-year-old man last night that began as a medical call.
There was a person out there who was having trouble breathing. Deputies responded with Brevard Fire Rescue, and it was determined that a male had suffered a gunshot wound. And he was taken to the hospital and unfortunately was pronounced deceased.
The sheriff's office says that man was shot with a .22 caliber air rifle, but the sheriff's office isn't saying much about what the woman who fired that weapon said to them. We were told, however, the situation was domestic related.
There's not been an arrest made at this time. Investigators are still going through everything, doing interviews just to make sure that they have a good idea of exactly what led to this incident.
The sheriff's office says the people who were at the residence at the time of the shooting have been cooperative. When investigators cleared the scene, we went back to that house where the shooting happened to see if anyone there would speak to us, but no one there was ready to talk. I did ask the sheriff's office about previous calls for service to this residence, and I'm reviewing that for Eyewitness News at 5. Live here in Port St. John, Melanie Holt, Channel 9 Eyewitness News.